All right, so we're back. This is Sense and Sentimentalism. I am Wheelord.
I'm Petpluto.
We did a little bit of work. Oh, this is Mass Effect 2, Episode 5, by the way.
There we go.
We did a little work between the last episode and this episode. We did two DLCs. We did the just the Normandy crash site, which has, like, nothing. And we actually did one other that the Overlord, I think. Project Overlord one, which I actually didn't do my first time through. I just found it.
It was like a Phryne.
It was, yeah, and we didn't do it because we were like, the DLC rarely ever has anything to do with this.
Yeah.
And it didn't have anything to do with the story, but it was such a good Phryne Fisher story. Yeah, Project Overlord would have been a great episode, and we didn't realize till we get to the end, because you don't realize you're in a Phryne episode until the end.
It's true. It's true.
And so we are going to go... And we're going to get Mordin, because I also went and did a ton of planet scanning.
Like a lot.
Like a freaking lot of it.
We completely mined an Elcor planet, potentially killing many, many Elcor.
I like to think that those Elcor lived.
I like to think those Elcor lived, but I also think that, you know, they may have, we may have killed
them. We may have killed them.
We may be the worst person.
But I think they're fine. But anyway, we have all this ore and nothing to do with it, so we need our scientists. So we're going to go get Mordin.
Yes.
And then I think the episode after that, we are... What is it? Oh, this is where we just did our thing. I never mind this place, but I'll be back.
You don't want to watch it mine.
You don't. It's really... Like, I enjoy it, but it's not good watching.
It's very... maybe if you were looking for, like, a therapeutic... Like, somebody organizing garden...
After Phryne night, I found it very therapeutic.
There is some, yeah, Phryne night did not go well for you.
It was a bad night to be a pet owner. Our cats are alive, they're just evil.
They're not evil, they're just sick.
So we're gonna go get the professor at Omega, and then we're going to go to the Citadel and get the Master Thief. Because that'll open up a lot of grinding and side quest stuff that I can do... off screen?
Yes.
Because we're getting to this point where it's really hard for me to do stuff off screen, with the exception of, you know...
Planet mining,
which I do enjoy, but you can only tolerate so much of.
Also, eventually you're just going to lose that. You're going to run out of planets.
That's going to take me a while.
How many planets are there?
We did one galaxy out of, like, 25.
That's a lot of planets.
Yes.
You could just like literally do that.
And I'm angry that you don't get money for it in this game like you did in the last game because we're so poor. We're so very poor.
Why aren't you wearing? Why are your shoes muddy?
Because I'm poor. Yeah, exactly. That's how we are right now.
I don't understand how we're so poor when we had so much money in the last game.
We apparently hid all of our money under our mattress, and our mattress was under the Normandy, and the Normandy got destroyed.
God damn it, Joker. We might have had time to save our money if you hadn't...
Had to save you.
Yes.
We are Grunkle Stan. We're just secretly like, ah. All right. We're going to go into a quarantine zone. As always, we're bringing Garrus because Garrus...
I still can't believe his loyalty level's at normal. Are we going to put him in his fancy new suit that you purchased for him?
You know what?
Let's put him in his fancy
I don't
fancy
know
new suit.
How. We bought the character pack, but God help me, I don't know how to put him in it.
Oh, no.
And it won't let me back out of here. Do we want Jacob? Do we want Miranda? Or do we want Zahid?
I mean, I believe either Jacob or Miranda.
You really haven't taken a liking to Uncle Zahid, have you?
I have not.
We did everything else with Miranda, and I honestly don't really like Miranda as, like, helper.
Okay.
So we're going to go to Jacob.
I like Jacob.
Jacob seems like a better guy. Seems like we're going to do in a morally ambiguous area, so we're going to bring Jacob.
Yes.
Oh,
look, he's got points. Only three, though, so I can't give him the full...
Yeah, I'm not gonna...
Okay, I have a stupid question for
you. Ooh. Here's a loadout. Maybe I can choose an outfit. Nope.
Oh, man.
We bought you that nice outfit.
So you need, like, six... You can't just jump to three. You have to literally go one, two... Like, when you're assigning points, right?
No, you... Well, yeah, you have to do 1, 2, and 3, so you have to spend the points
like
on 1
points.
And 2. Yeah.
That's awful.
Why? You have to build up to it. it's training. Like, you're at level one. All right, now you're at level two. It's like, all right, I've trained up to level three. You can't just be like, I'm starting at level three. Forget level one and two.
I just think that if you're, like, the kind of person who saves points, you should get a bonus for that.
That's... No, it's like you're getting better at something. It's like we were rock wall climbing today, and when you get to the pink course, you will have gotten better. You can't just be like, I've been going to the gym, and I think I'm going to start at the pink course.
I mean, you could do that.
Not really, because it's about skill and strength.
I know.
You don't have the skill.
I mean, by I don't know way, if I'm ever going to make it to the pink course. I fell several times today.
By the way, pink course is only the second least difficult one.
Only if you're bouldering. If you're top roping, it's like in the middle.
Where am I?
I don't know.
I want to take a hard left.
Because we've been bouldering, and we thought we were really bad.
But it turns out we're, in fact, quite good.
I mean, you're pretty good.
For a starter.
I'm still pretty bad.
I, by the way, feel like the guy from Kung Pao when she's strengthening up his hands and he's like, you broke a thermometer on my hand. That is current hand level right now. There's a
plague. Nobody gets interrupt. I mean, I fell so hard that my glasses bounced to the side of my head.
She's wearing that outfit that I wanted our Lady Fisher to be wearing. I own is in that apartment. Yeah, you fell in a very cartoony, like, there would have been, like, a dust ball with swears coming off, and I fell in a way that it would have just been a hole in the ground in my shape.
Don't you get lost, lady. The plague has the whole zone quarantined. Nobody gets in.
I'm human, you ass. Humans can't get the plague. Now let me get my stuff out before looters get it.
This thing affects every other race out there. We're not taking chances. Nobody gets in until the plague has run its course.
Who do you even work for?
I mean, that's an excellent question.
I didn't think Omega had any kind of law enforcement. Who gave the order to quarantine the slums?
Fresh off the transport, huh? Arya Talok calls the shots.
Arya said I could go.
She's got her little blue hands on every business in this district. And a plague is bad for business.
One would think so. It would be tenements.
Anyone from entering or leaving the quarantine zone.
I feel like a stupid follow-up question is in order.
So you're saying the slums are completely sealed off?
Finally, a human that can hear. Yes, that's exactly what I'm saying.
You can't keep me out. I'm gonna lose all my stuff.
Who's gonna loot you if everyone's there? Human.
Anybody in the quarantine zone will be dead from the plague.
But we
of the gangs and
can't
plagues.
Get it, apparently.
There's a Solarian named Mordin Solis in the slums. I've got to get in there to find him.
The doctor? Yeah, crazy bastard opened a clinic in the district a few months ago.
Oh my god.
Blue Suns went
does
to
it hurt to does it hurt to maneuver
when
the
I
buttons?
Do this yes.
Yes. Yes, that was me yesterday when like when I was trying to fight in those epic down. Battles and I was like wait, my hand
the plague of the Blue Suns kill everyone then go in and clean up.
I didn't think diseases could cross species barriers. Turians and Solarians can't even eat the same food.
They can't
right. No, Turians and Quarians can't eat the same food as everyone else.
Loose,
they eat similar food.
And seeing wait, how Turians and Quarians eat similar food?
Yeah. A bit of looting. A lot of but I think even they can't help each other. They just eat a similar type of thing, and then everyone else basically eats like...
Right. Investigate?
So we yeah, can... so... Blue Suns.
Blue Suns.
Well, come on!
We know who they are! At least
they used to. Some dialogue options should just disappear.
Yes. Unless you want Phryne to look like an idiot.
Or change it to be like, what are the Blue Suns doing there?
Yes, like, I thought that was going to be the thing. Like, is this where they're headquartered?
See, the Vorcha are making a move. They're immune too. But no.
Nature's
tell
plague.
Me more about this plague.
That starts out as a cough. Then you start coughing blood. And, well, then I shoot you.
Okay.
It affects multiple species. Turians, Solarians, Krogan, you name it. Only humans are immune. And Vorcha, if you count them.
No, I
don't.
Airborne
disease that takes down multiple races. Can't let that spread.
You know what? I agree. I actually agree with you, Turian man.
Any idea where I can find Morden's clinic?
You know,
in there.
Walk in there.
What do you care? Place is quarantined, remember?
Let me in and I'll
listen,
help.
You're stuck here till this quarantine's over. That could take weeks.
It could.
What you really need is to get this problem solved right now. That's what I do.
Solve problems.
And get this woman's stuff so that it doesn't get looted.
You think you can fix this?
No. Ugh. No, I don't, but that's okay.
I'm going to zoom the camera in a little bit.
Anyway, I'll radio ahead, tell them you're coming in.
Ugh.
You're stopping me, but not them? You son of a bitch.
Well, you're not going to help stop the plague, ma'am.
Oh, no. No. Why am I like this?
I don't know. Zone for a
plague that it's really because I want to put my legs up, but I don't want to like be relaxing on camera.
It all makes sense now. Why don't we...
Okay, don't worry, you'll stay.
Yeah, keep him out of there. I mean, I love you, Garrus, but you can't come with us.
It's safer to stick with a squad who's immune to the plague.
It's your call, Shepard. If you need me, I'm not going to let a cough keep me back.
No, Garrus.
I think you should...
What? No!
No, we don't just wave him in!
No. No, 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 no. Let's just go get Ashley. Or Zaid. We basically got only one person on our crew.
Who can't come in here, and we brought him, and he's coming in with us?
Yeah, I did not think that. I didn't remember.
Is he gonna die?
Yeah, he is.
You're gonna kill Garrus?
I mean, you know how you can save him?
How?
By reading Garrus fanfic.
That's not gonna save
Which
Garrus.
I happen to have some of
that
right
That is not
here.
Gonna save Garrus.
So Zaid or Miranda?
Go with, well, which one was better?
Honestly, I'm gonna break in Zaid a little bit. We haven't really used him at all.
Alright, but if he kills somebody like Rex did, I'm gonna be a lot less forgiving.
Alright, well, I'm going to pull up some fanfic.
Because you're evil?
Because it's literally what people watch this show for. Our episodes with fanfic have 3 to 4 times the numbers of our episodes without fanfic.
I don't understand that. We are delightful.
Yes, we are. There's one that takes place between ME1 and 2 where Shep comes and crashes on Garrus's couch.
I'll read
which
that.
Which doesn't even canonically make sense, but here you go.
Maybe it was like during one of their
you know,
weeks
do you want to do it on your phone so that like I can look up stuff? I'll send you the link.
All right.
That way if I need to look anything up, I don't have to like disturb you.
I'm moving this water bottle because it's been digging into me.
That's fine. Come on.
Come on.
Petra. Paste. There we go.
Did you send it to my Facebook?
Yes. Cool. I want there to be a permanent record of this in someone's database.
Why do you hate me?
Because I'm the best. Synthetics
okay.
And shields.
So this is Curiosity by Quandem. Summary. When the Reapers ravage Palavin, some of the Turians on Mene pass the time by trading stories about the species they've bedded. Garrus enlightens them on what it's like to be with a human. Oh, Garrus!
What? You're reading the wrong one.
It's the one you just sent me.
No, this is... I know
it's the
one
you
I just
sent me.
Look, I know it's what I just sent you, but it's not the one I just told you about. I must have clicked the wrong link in
my
email.
I thought maybe that this was like him reminiscing.
No,
about
this
the time.
Is supposed to be beating like a no, not beating like a hammer. Well, fuck. Garrus's couch and smut ensues. Let me check if it's this one.
No, it's by the same author.
Yep.
All right, so I'm gonna go in. I'm gonna click on her
Look
name.
Look for well dot fuck.
Okay.
Or I can send you the link. I don't know why it had the link right there. Like, why is there no map? I hate the lack of maps in this game. Also, I think Red Bull makes me sleepy now. Because, like, I was fine until we drank it, and now I'm sleepy. And then yesterday, before Land Party Legacy, I drank it, and then I almost passed out during Land Party Legacy.
Well, fuck. On both accounts.
You're welcome. I haven't previewed any of these, by the way.
When he least expects it, Garrus finds Shepard at the door of his apartment on the Citadel. Looking
hey.
For what?
No, I'm just like, this guy popped up, but he's ignoring us, and I find that rude.
That is rude.
Get me over? No?
Looking for a place to spend the night. Okay.
But Shepard's dead.
Okay.
Unless it's like in the 2 weeks
it's
before.
It's literally when they had like
2 weeks in between one and the opening of two?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Arwen looks so silly with that knot just puffed up there.
She watched some punk films, and she has a little kitten mohawk now.
Okay. There was a familiarity to the situation in which he sat. A cup of spiced herbal water gone cold and leaving a wet ring on the desk. His
Pause.
Pri-
sorry. The graphics, I've been getting really annoyed at how freaking dark everything is recently.
Mm-hmm.
And I can barely see here. There we go, I can see, sorry.
Okay. His private terminal open and on. Its screen unchanged over the last few minutes, and Garrus's finger poised over the enter key, letting his future hover in that state of flux between risk and reward. Years ago, in that very apartment, Garrus was sure that the scene had been exactly the same, including the hour of the night it was.
Oh! Oh,
dear God!
Oh! Oh, my. Well, Zaid just saved our lives.
Thank you, Uncle Zaid. Thank you, Grunkle Zaid.
Grunkle Zaid? Why do we even have that gun out?
I
guess they just left the dead in the street.
Listen, Jacob, I understand that this is upsetting, but you're gonna need to get your shit together.
Alright, sorry, go back to your spot. I was just caught by surprise.
Years ago, in that very apartment, Garrus was sure the scene had been exactly the same, including the hour of the night it was, as he waited for the precise moment for the courage to find him and hit submit on the data file that was his formal application to the council, seeking admittance and acknowledgement and becoming a specter.
Steal my possessions.
You need help.
Is there anything I can do for you?
Get away from me, human. Your kind has done too much already. Your plague did this to me.
I feel like we should have asked, there should have been an our plague option. Don't blame us for this.
Humans didn't create this plague.
Well, we don't really know that.
You, those were on the...
Let me tell you, that is very poetic there, Batharian. Batharian.
Your species is the only
and Vorcha.
And Vorcha. Maybe it's the Vorcha. Maybe they're smarter than anyone gives them credit for.
And the wretched Vorcha.
I'm looking for a Solarian. Let's completely switch this.
Humans looking for the human sympathizer. I hope the Vorcha burned Mordin and his clinic to the ground.
Okay.
I hope you... Damn it. Damn you. Can't.
Did you just go invisible?
No, I did a Paragon, because she's a nurse.
Good. Does he have eyes all the way up his skull?
Yeah, they're Batarians.
Yeah, right.
Did we metagel him? I imagine we metageled him.
I'm here to help.
I do. I don't know if I can find a cure for this plague, but I'm going to try.
Your words sound sincere.
But you know, the Vorcha have like four eyes, six eyes.
Oh, so like those
not the Vorcha, sorry, the Batarians.
So those little holes are like going all the way down his skull. That's something different, right?
I think so.
Humans in the plague. Let's start there.
Let's start with Mordin.
Okay, fine. Let's start with
I need to find Mordin's solace.
He has a clinic on the far side of the district.
I think they might only have four eyes. Everything else is like Klingon ridges.
Offering to help those infected with the plague.
All right. Yeah.
I was afraid to go to him before. He's dangerous, but perhaps he can help.
What makes Mordin worse than dying from the plague?
The Blue Suns tried to press him for protection money. He killed them. Stunned them with some kind of toxin.
I love Mordin. He's one of my favorite characters in the entire series.
Wow.
What?
I'm just like reading this and being like, whoa.
And display the bodies as a warning.
That's not usually what they do. You're right.
That's a little unusual.
Yeah. This doesn't happen with normal doctors.
Potent to be a naturally occurring virus. Airborne transmission across numerous species. Near perfect mortality rate. It had to be created in a lab.
Yeah.
And since humans are the only species...
Unless we're too new and you don't know enough about our biology.
Maybe.
Aren't the Vorcha immune to the plague? What if they spread the virus so they could take over the district?
Because they're not smart.
Vorcha. Are immune to disease.
In general.
A human-created plague wouldn't affect them. But if the Vorcha created the plague, why wouldn't it affect humans?
Because they're immune to disease.
Oh, I get it.
Why male models?
Why male models?
They're scavengers.
Okay.
Oh my god, this is ice cold and it feels so good on my burning hands.
To believe it, but all the evidence points to your species.
I mean, I believe it. I do. Phryne doesn't, but I do.
I'll send someone to help disappeared, so...
He has a clinic. I was afraid to go to
there
him
we
before.
Go.
He is dangerous.
When I find Mordin, I'll tell him about you. If he has a cure, I'll make sure someone...
Grunkle... Our Grunkle does not seem to give a fuck.
My time is running short. But at least you have given me a flicker of hope to brighten the darkness
of my
god.
You're a very poetic Batarian. You should maybe have considered a different career path.
I will risk
Goodbye.
I should go.
Because you're dying. You know, gotta get away from you. Alright. Sighed aloud at his reluctance. Okay. What?
I was gonna say, in a horrible twist of fate, we're gonna actually not get the virus, but it's gonna be on us, and we're gonna infect Garrus and kill him. We're gonna bring it back to the ship.
Son of a bee, man. He sighed aloud at his reluctance, arms raised to cross behind his head while eyes never strayed from the screen that held his fate. There would be no one to interfere this time. His father long since retired from CSEC, and after the Battle of the Citadel, he was not just a nameless base. He actually had a shot, and was perhaps what... Hey!
What? Kitten battle?
Kitten battle! I'm reading here! They're trying to share the same sunbeam. Gia does not share well.
You're really bad at reading these for more than a sentence or two at a time.
I got distracted by kitten battle. He actually had a shot, and that was perhaps what left him hesitating at the finish line. Garrus leaned back in his desk chair, and a squeak resounded at the shift in weight. It was enough of a welcomed opening for him. Brow plate raised in question as his eyes finally tore away from the dreaded screen. He shifted forward in his seat, then back again, testing for the consistency in the chair's misbehavior, and again did it let out a whining groan, this one louder than before. Huh. He rose and turned the chair over, examining the underside for any obvious signs of anything a touch out of place. It was business as usual, but he remained unconvinced and unsatisfied, returning to the object in question with a set of tools and a small bottle of oil. It was cathartic to take the chair apart, piece by piece, first separating the actual seat from the base and then disassembling the piston and the mechanism that allowed the seat to slight or climb. The process was methodical, no attention to detail spared as he cleaned each piece of dust and grease buildup, lining them up like he would have the parts of a gun after a particularly grueling mission beside Shepard and Rex. That was more good gun maintenance and being prepared for anything, however, and less about avoiding real life on behalf of an ill-fated squeak. Were we sent this? Or did you just stumble?
We were sent this. This is one of the ones we were sent in the initial batch.
Ah!
I haven't been listening to you. I've been listening to this. What have I been missing?
Garrus just took apart a desk chair.
Well, why?
It was squeaking.
Huh?
It was squeaking?
Oh, I mean, could he come and work on my computer chair? Because it's also squeaking and it's also grinding into the hardwood.
Yeah, we gotta stop that. Garrus was knee-deep in washers and screws when the bell of the apartment entrance rang, lifting his head in a curious glance back towards the tiny entranceway as he ran a washer through an old rag. Things had been quiet around here lately. The reporters seeking a comment had died down weeks ago, and even the old seasick buddy stopping by to say hello had run thin as time distanced him from Saren's ultimate end. What short attention spans they all had. It rang again, and though it was just a single tone, Garrus swore he could almost hear the insistence in the sound, the inanimate object capturing the interloper's eagerness. Before he could even reach the door, it rang for a third time, and Garrus's nose wrinkled in air in irritation at the unknown. Spirits, he mumbled to himself, and pounded the side of his fist into the door's nearby control panel, automatically triggering the unlocking protocol. On the other side was perhaps the last person he ever expected, Commander Shepard. Surprise! The bag on her shoulder left her weight unevenly distributed, body hunched slightly to one side, feet planted apart. Spectre that she was, Shepard would always be Alliance first, and it was reflected in the off-duty uniform she wore, even if the blouse was half untucked at the waistband of her pants. For Shepard, that was downright fatherly. Commander. He greeted her stiffly but nervously, and immediately wiped his palms clean on the thighs of his cloth pants. Shepard quickly started in. I know what you're thinking, and that's why on Palavan is the illustrious, lips quirked in a smile. Beautiful, her voice dropped an octave, sultry in tone. And dangerous, Commander Shepard at my door. I'm just a lowly Turian, unworthy of her very presence. A laugh rumbled at the back of his throat, and he didn't bother to hold it back. To that I'd reply that yes, you are very well beneath me. I am a council specter, after all. She winked her facade, otherwise serious. However, when I missed my shuttle off this glorified space station, I began to think, isn't there a happy Turian that flies that spot on my ship for weeks at a time? Surely, after the kindness I showed him, he would be happy to accept the honor of allowing me to sleep on his couch for the night. Ah, he nodded, playing along. I believe you call it quid pro quo. Quote. Besides, and she reached into her bag, fighting the zipper for half a moment before she was able to grasp the item she desired. Shepard held up the glass bottle of candy liquid, cradling it to her chest like a proud parent with their newborn infant. With innocent eyes through thick lashes, she glanced up to him and asked, "Could you be so cold-hearted to turn us out?" Gara stepped aside, arm waving her in. Shepard wasted no time in taking advantage, and when she was far enough in the apartment to turn around, she did so, this time presenting the bottle of alcohol to him. "No, no." His head and hands shook. "I don't know if I'm ready for the responsibility of parenthood just yet. You can't prove it's mine." "I knew that's what you'd say." Diving into her still open bag, she produced another similar bottle, though this one held a blue liquid in its label in Turian script rather than the human markings that were featured on the first. "That's why I didn't tell you it was actually twins. And look!" Her arms full as she juggled the bottle, raising the second one as high as it would go as she affectionately nuzzled her cheek and jaw against the glass. "He even has your eyes. Congratulations, Papa. It's a hangover in a bottle. You must be so proud." Damn, he hadn't realized how much he'd missed her. Missed the Normandy, the camaraderie, the entirety of the crew, including Shepard, yes. But just her? It hadn't even occurred to him to miss the human that much. How long is this? Okay, almost 14,000 words.
So it's really long?
Well, 14,000 words.
Well, we've got an hour. If you want to do a different one, we can. But
nope, I'm already.
You kind of jumped into this without checking these things.
I did, because you were like, read this one on there. All right.
Well, it seemed like it would have bridged that gap. It was canonically like correct.
Been rehearsing that long. He moved to help her with the bottles, and Shepard nodded her thanks as she was finally able to set her bag down.
Is what I hear right? This plague doesn't affect humans?
No. Seems like some kind of bioweapon or something, since it affects so many different species. The Blue Suns figure humans caused it. They're shooting us on sight. God knows how many have already died.
They should be looking at the fortune, not us. Ever since the plague hit, they've been taking over Blue Suns territory.
Investigate.
You said the Vorcha moved in just after the plague hit?
Right after the district was quarantined. Vorcha are immune to diseases, so they're not getting sick.
Not sure where they came from. Never saw many Vorcha around before. Sure seemed like they were ready for this.
Only nobody thinks the Vorcha are smart enough to create a virus like this. The Blue Suns need someone else to blame. Like us.
Where are the Vorcha?
You said the Vorcha were taking over Blue Suns territory?
Trying to. The Blue Suns don't go down easy. The plague softened.
Yes, they do.
Have enough firepower to hold.
See last episode.
Turians are getting pushed back. The deeper you go into the district, the more Vorcha you'll see. Unless they see you first.
What else can you tell me about the plague? When did it start?
The first cases cropped up about 2 weeks ago. Nobody paid much attention until it started to spread. Usually takes about a week to kill you, but it spreads fast. 3 days after the first outbreak, there were over 50 known cases.
That's when everyone noticed humans weren't getting
plague.
Sick. Then the quarantine came down and everything went to hell.
Sahara?
Ah!
Any idea how the victims contracted it?
Not sure.
What do you call probably it? Airborne. A plague.
Even after the blue
how many people does it need to be a plague? 5? 50?
Apartments, the plague kept spreading. Now they just gun victims down and burn the bodies in the streets. Doesn't seem to be helping, though. People are dying by the dozens.
Blue Suns.
Tell me more about the Blue Suns.
Oh, my abs.
They're a mercenary gang, mostly Turian. Used to run this district. Kept things nice and stable for the most part.
Okay.
As long as you paid your monthly protection fees, everything was cool. Rates were pretty reasonable. For Omega, at least.
Why do you live here? Unless
why
you're bad
you
people.
Like, seriously,
this
I don't
is not
understand.
Alliance criminal territory. Like, did you have to flee?
Maybe they had to flee.
Into a war zone.
I need to find Mordin Solus.
Oh, yeah. Him. He's got a
like
clinic
him.
On the
do you have a map
side?
Of the district so I can know what the
seriously.
Other side is? I'm just taking random turns, and I've definitely missed a few.
Yep.
Sure. A doctor with military-grade mechs helping people for free. On Omega, grow up.
You don't trust Mordin?
Sounds like you don't think much of the doctor in his clinic.
The Vorcha tried to muscle in. He gunned them down. Just like that. Pop, pop, pop. Didn't even use his mechs.
Then the Blue Suns heard he was sheltering humans and they went to burn down the clinic. He killed them too. Then he went inside and got back to work. He's cold. Must be Solarian special forces or something.
You should really go to
can't
the clinic.
Stay trapped in this apartment.
I walked in. Like, I literally just walked
yeah.
in.
Yeah.
Are you nuts? We'd never make it. The streets are crawling with blue suns and Vorcha. We don't even have pistols.
Why do you live on Omega?
Why do you live on Omega?
I'm not risking my life on a rumor that some Salarian might offer me sanctuary.
I'll get you there.
You're scared, but your only hope is to get to Morden's clinic. I'm gonna be under fire from the blue suns and the Vorcha, so
didn't I just say I'll take you there?
I thought you just said that.
I'll do what I can to leave a safe path for you to follow me.
Our choice was literally, I will take you there.
Okay.
And she's like,
we'll never make it if
we're I won't be taking you with me.
We have to try. We'll wait here for a while and give you time to clear the way. Then we'll head for Morden's clinic, if we're lucky.
I can barely make a fist and hold this controller. How about now? My hands are on fire.
Been rehearsing that long, he moved to help her with the bottles, and Shepard nodded her thanks as she was finally able to set her bag down. She rubbed her shoulder, sore from the weight of it. Only since the liquor store, Jesus! She paused halfway in the main living space of his apartment, eyeing the mess of the nondescript metal bits across his floor. You assembling an IED? Something I should know about, Garrus? He placed the bottles on the kitchen counter that overlooked the living room and joined her where she stood. Well.
My legs were up on the seat that Arwen runs across, and she sat there staring at my legs like, excuse me! And I finally moved them, and she jumped up and climbed the couch really quickly.
Oh, good for her.
This should come in handy.
And joined her where she stood. There was a sigh and then a shake of his head. He'd completely forgotten. If I'd known you were coming, I wouldn't have, but there was a squeak. Eyebrows raised and her hands sat on her hips, her body canted at the waist ever so slightly to eye him. A squeak? You know, when it reclines, it squeaks. So you took it apart. For a squeak.
I would. I'm with you, Garrus. I mean, I say I wouldn't. Obviously, I wouldn't because my computer chair. I'm a busy man. You know how long it takes to make this show and LPL and Hill We Die On and have a full-time job and keep this body
and
take care of you?
I mean, taking care of me should be, like, priority one.
It is priority one.
Good. So you took it apart for a squeak? Well, I didn't have anything better to do. Remind me not to let you get near the Mako again. And with that, she punched her shoulder playfully.
I mean, he's never, ever, ever taken care of the Mako, see Mass Effect 1.
Oh, so no! Again. He kept it as good as he possibly could have.
Holy shit!
That guy's on fire.
Yeah, Zaid shot him with a shotgun.
Holy crap, man. I'd hate to think of what you'd do to her if you heard it squeak and happened to be bored. No worse than what you do when you drive it, he protested.
Have a nice trip.
I agree with Garrus then. You're not a good driver.
Me?
Well, Phryne, you.
Oh, I was a great driver.
Hey, I won't have you mocking my driving on shore leave. This is a judgment-free zone. You're in my apartment, Shepard. Well, by some kind of Spectre authority I don't know of, I'm temporarily commandeering this apartment and declaring it a no-mocking Shepard zone. Or are you going to arrest me if I don't follow orders? Shepard seemed to pause to think out the reply.
Sorry, I shot a guy with a flamethrower in his backpack and blew him up.
Oh. There's no clever quip to follow her, though. No graceful sparring of the words. Instead, she just bumped her hip into his as they continued to stare at the pile of
people got no shield.
The desk chair. Normandy hasn't been the same without you. He too softened. It wasn't an outright declaration of her missing him, but in Shepard's own way, that's exactly what. I'm not complaining, he said, curiosity in his voice, but what are you doing here? Shepard pulled away, making a beeline for where her peace offering sat on one of the counters in the small office. Military life left her with the ability to make herself at home anywhere, and it took Shepard nearly a moment to get herself acquainted with this place. She opened cabinet after cabinet. I told you. Missed my shuttle, she answered quickly. You got cups? Left of the sink. No. Your other left.
Oh, she's you.
Gotcha, she declared. I only know left. I don't know right. It'd be right of the sink. No, the other right.
Get over here!
Looks like we're in fortune territory.
You think, Jacob?
Well, I mean, they're probably dying of the plague.
Hey, can Garrus have your armor?
Oh.
His is kind of blown up.
We bought a pack and everything to stop that from happening.
Yeah, I gotta find out how to give him armor. We bought that pack, by the way, not just because we felt bad for Garrus, but because Jack doesn't believe in clothing.
I don't know Jack yet, but I fully believe that most
people should
have
clothing.
Just that people should, you know? Clothing's good. In war zones.
Petra's from New England.
I am. And clothing is definitely good in war zones. I feel like that's just a thing.
Sorry, you can go ahead.
Gotcha, she declared, and pulled out a pair of low-rising glasses.
We found this stuff. It's ours.
Ah, forget it. Nothing but junk in here. This place is worse than the last one.
I'm looking for someone.
Do you know a Solarian named Mordin Solus?
Yeah, I know him. Got a clinic right
around the
corner.
Oh, thank God, we're across town.
Take plenty of ammo if you go that way. It's crawling with blue suns and vorture.
Plague.
What else can you tell me
about
the plague? Plague.
I don't know. Started about a week ago.
Two.
I think.
Two.
Aliens started dying off left and right, and they quarantined the district.
Figured we had to look out for ourselves. Started scoping out some apartments, taking what we could carry.
Never really found much. Kind of a poor neighborhood.
What were you doing in here if it wasn't your neighborhood?
The blue suns used to keep them down. But with all the suns getting sick, the Vorcha are making a push to take over the district. Yeah, don't know who's going to come out on top. We just want to stay the hell out of the way.
Tell me everything you know about Mordin Solus.
That guy is crazy. He'll patch up a gunshot wound for free, then kick your ass and throw you out when you try to grab a few painkillers.
Well, he's really painful.
Be honest, man. You kind of had that coming.
Yeah.
No way he's just a doctor. No doctor puts down a Blue Sun squad like that.
All I know is if you go to his clinic, don't cause any trouble.
I won't.
The Blue Suns control this district, right?
Well, they used to, before the plague wiped half of them out. Seems like it won't be long until the Vorcha finish them off. Yeah, I'm kind of sorry to see him go. Blue Suns ran a tight ship. Kept the district in line for the most part.
That's it, right?
Yep.
We need to get going.
Well, stay here for a while. Get some rest.
Good for you.
Sorry, we had a kitten thing we had to check on.
Kitten emergencies, man.
Oh, potential. Turned out to be false flag.
False flag kitten emergencies. Pulled out a pair of low-rising glasses. Shepard raised them to him in a sign of victory and then sent them on the counter, opening the bottles. First, second, his. Each got a generous helping, and before she'd even handed his glass over, Shepard was downing hers with a little too much enthusiasm. I'll catch one out tomorrow, she supplied, but avoided his gaze and poured another serving of the burning liquid. Her movements, which had been quick and erratic, suddenly slowed, and finally, since he'd found her outside of his apartment door, Shepard seemed to take a real pause, loaded with apprehension. If you're busy or just don't have the room. Had he known she was coming, he would have made preparations, would have cleaned, cleared the clutter, made arrangements so that the apartment was a better fit for a human guest rather than just the lonely Turian who resided there on his own. To say his place was a bachelor pad was an understatement. Not that Garrus believed Shepard would ever bring a feminine touch to her own place anyway, but still. The thought of the commander existing in the same room as all of his personal mess, well, it was unsettling. But it was also too late to do anything about that now. I'm not sure how comfortable you'll be here, but you're always welcome, he stated with a nod, and took a sip of the alcohol she offered. It wasn't his favorite, not by a long shot, but the knowledge that it had been brought as a gift made the taste a little easier on his palate.
Please don't shoot me.
No funny business once you're in the clinic, unless you want to deal with those mechs.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Do I have to jump over the counter to get in?
No.
Oh.
He is a receptionist.
Oh, nice.
Mordin's around here somewhere. Go talk to him. We need all the help we can get.
Oh, you don't even know if I'm here for, you know.
Are you a Vorcha? No, you're a Turian. Turian patient. Other receptionist.
Sorry, too busy to stop and chat. You should go find Mordin.
Okay.
Mordin saved my life.
Does have a cure.
Oh, good. I don't know, why not?
No, we, so, humans no, he can't doesn't. Get it, Mordin.
Yeah, that's what he's saying. That's why it's not an option. He's trying to figure out what the thing is.
I can use this.
I'll be out of your fringe before you know it. Promise.
Oh, she called it a fringe.
I know. Hey. He said, and gently touched her elbow for a half a second, looking to still her. You're welcome here, Shepard, for as long as you need. Her eyes met his, holding the gaze until she felt she could take no more. As always, there was a kind of genuine warmth there, the same look that had often brought her down to visit him during his time on her ship.
Sorry, I keep interrupting you, but soon we'll be in a shooting off point.
Okay.
Don't recognize you from Maria. Too well armed to be refugees, no mercenary uniform, quarantine still in effect.
Yes.
Here for something else. Fortune, crew to clean them out, unlikely. Fortune, a symptom, not a cause. The plague, investigating possible uses bioweapon. No. Too many guns, not enough data, equipment. Soldier, not scientist. Yes.
Not doing the right
thing. Maybe. Looking for something.
Relax, yes. Mordin. I'm Commander Shepard, and I came here to find you. I'm on a critical mission, and I need your help.
Mission? What mission?
I think that might have been our first prompt that we ignored.
Wow. Clearly understand. Plague is spreading too fast. Who sent you?
Cerberus.
Ever heard of an organization called Cerberus?
Crossed paths on occasion. Thought they only worked with humans. Why request Solarian aid?
We're after the Collectors.
I'm on a mission to shut down the Collectors, and I need your help.
Collectors? Interesting. Plague hitting these slums is engineered. Collectors, one of few groups with technology to design it. Our goals may be similar. But must stop plague first. Already have a cure. Need to distribute it at Environmental Control Center. Vorcha guarding it. Need to kill them.
I'll take care.
I'll get in and deal with the Vorcha.
What the hell was that?
Vorcha have shut down environmental systems. Trying to kill everyone. Need to get power back on before District suffocates. Here, take plague cure. Also, bonus in good faith. Weapon from Dead Blue Sun's Mercs may come in handy against Vorcha. One more thing.
Wow.
Daniel, one of my assistants, went into Vorcha territory looking for victims. Hasn't come back.
I'll keep an eye out.
If I see him, I'll do what I can to help.
Thank you. Told him not to go. But he's smart. Bright future. I hope.
I met a sick Batarian.
I found a Batarian plague victim near the entrance to the neighborhood. Can you send someone to help him?
Risky. Blue Sun's Vorcha still battling. District not secure. See what I can do.
Plague.
What can you tell me about this plague?
Advanced design. Suspected collectors before you mentioned them. Purpose seems experimental. Destroys respiratory systems with harmful genetic mutations. Makes sense to avoid humans. Unnecessary to force mutation on human genetic structure for sake of variants.
Why does it make sense?
Unnecessary mutations? What are you talking about?
Possible goal of virus. Testing viable mutation levels in various species. Horrific, but feasible for collectors. Humans known to have diverse genetic background. Wider range than other sapient races. Makes sense as control group.
Ah! Vorcha.
What do you know about the Vorcha?
I love Vorcha.
Cowardly, opportunistic scavengers. Not tactical or aggressive. Scale of attack unusual for them. Suspect Vorcha working for collectors. Distributing plague, collecting data. No proof, but theory fits evidence.
Any idea where I can find Daniel?
No. Heard infected Batarians trapped behind Vorcha lines. Daniel went to help. Warned him not to go. Too dangerous. Patients here need him. Stuck out anyway. Wanted to find him myself. Can't leave the clinic. Have to look after the patients.
Have you had any trouble at the clinic?
Nothing major. Blue Suns gave her humans, made threats, killed them before things escalated.
For a doctor, you're awfully calm about taking out a group of mercs.
Wasn't always a doctor. Some work with Solarian Special Tasks Group. Can handle myself.
That's how he lost one of his little head.
I know, I was looking at that, I was like, you're missing like an antenna, dude.
Coming.
I should go.
Let's head for the environmental plant.
Nice!
The following, oh good. I thought it said not able.
I got a better handgun.
Well, that's great, but I thought it said not able, and I was like, son of a bitch, none of us can use this! This is awful! As a gesture of good faith, I'm going to give you a handgun none of you can use.
Weapon loadout locker.
Ooh. Okay. Her eyes met his, holding the gaze until she felt she could take no more. As always, there was a kind of genuine warmth there, the same look that had often brought her down to visit him during his time on her ship. Shepard couldn't help but smile, though it started small and grew slowly, dimples forming over her cheeks when it was in full bloom. She touched him right back, fingers to his own sharper elbow. Let's get you another drink, and then I want to hear all about what you've been doing without me. The night passed, measured not in hours gone, but in the slowly sinking line of alcohol in their respective bottles. For his size, Garrus had been the one to put away more of his heat, but potent liquor. Though it was Shepard who drank with abandon, and it didn't take him long to realize it was done with a purpose. She was burying something, drowning herself in alcohol to keep something else faded away. He wanted to ask all night, ever since her first nervous word of greeting him outside of his apartment, but it hadn't seemed right. Baby Shepard had earned the privilege of keeping her secrets to herself, even if Garrus knew that it was usually best to spill them out in the open where they lost their power to fester and spread like a cancer. Sherman had abandoned her glass some time before, hand curled around the narrowed neck of the bottle as it sat nestled in her lap. Her legs were curled up into each other, interlocking pieces.
I said bullshit. You can keep reading.
Interlocking pieces like a human child often sat. But even he was as baffled as he saw Shepard settle into the position with ease. Legs just didn't seem like they were supposed to bend that way, at least not to him. It brought a childishness to her, a friendly intimacy as they shared the floor together. Catch had been given up two human fingers with alcohol earlier. Had enough, he asked, and motioned his head in the direction of her drink of choice. She smiled wide, the kind of grins that only ever came with being intoxicated, at least for Shepard. No, not even close. For effect, she drew the bottle up, took a swig, not even wincing as the burn rinsed down her throat. Gareth smiled in his own way and held back his sigh for her. He parroted the action of drinking. He still used the cup, only slow, shallow sips. Only slow, shallow sips taken as of late, so she wasn't alone, and rested the glass back down on the floor beside him. So where are you headed? What? She looked up quickly, bewildered. You missed your flight out of here. Where are you going on your shore leave? The action of her swallow was visible, followed by another mouthful of the alcohol, done only to buy herself time. Shepard wiped her lips with her other hand, slouched forward as her elbows came to rest on her thigh. I don't know.
Sorry, this handgun has much less ammo, so I'm just like, oh no. You can proceed. I just had a horrible realization.
Okay. Her words were so pitiful that the guilt immediately covered him. For all the prying he'd wanted to do, he hadn't expected that. Garrus had every intention of letting the statement of indecision remain where it laid, but it was Shepard who broke the awkward silence. I had plans, she insisted, defending herself like a little lost orphan with nowhere to go. But I got into the dock and I couldn't. It was more trouble than it was worth. It would only make things worse. There were pieces of the story missing, the narration hard to follow, but he understood the basics at least. Friend? He inquired. Family wasn't an option for her. He knew that much about Commander Shepard. What family she once had no longer lived and breathed. He said a silent prayer to his spirits, reminded himself to call his mother, to ask about her visit to the doctor, to go bug his sister for the latest details on the goings-on in her life, and maybe even trade words with his father. Next to him, Shepard simultaneously gave a half-hearted shrug and a desperate, angered exhale of air. Something like that. What does that mean? Exactly what you think it means, she raised an eyebrow at him.
Sorry.
Can we try it again? Am I distracting you with this reading?
No. I mean, yes, but no. Keep reading.
His own brow plate shifted down at the furthest corners, expressing his confusion.
I came here to help you.
Oh.
We know you're spreading the plague virus. We saw the vials in your bag.
No. Those vials contain the cure. Please, you have to believe me.
Maybe we should cut off your fingers. That should look out. One more step and we kill your friend.
I know you're scared of the Vorcha, of the plague, but this man isn't to blame. If he was spreading the virus, why would he come into Vorcha territory? They're immune.
She's right. Doesn't make any sense.
Thank you, random Batarian.
You have my word on it.
Let him know.
I love that aliens seem to understand rationale.
Yeah.
You free to go?
You can go.
We had a deal.
Human nobility. I didn't know such a thing existed.
I
okay,
mean,
now
you're
shoot
the
them.
Dicks who took people hostage, so.
Gonna kill me. Did Mordin send you to find me?
He needs you.
Professor could use your help right now. He's got too many patients and not enough volunteers.
Yeah, okay. I'll go right away. Thanks again. I owe you, well, everything.
Okay, Daniel. Peace. He whistled, or at least it was the Turian equivalent of the sound. You know you can't not tell me about the person that Commander Shepard, savior of the Citadel, was going to bed, right? Consider it payment for spending the night. Shepard groaned, head shaking. Your honorable Turian sensibilities won't approve, Garrus. Yeah, well, I'm not a very good Turian, so try me. He's older. A bit older. Like, Udina older? Her mouth gaped, the expression of disgust over her features. You're a fucking sicko, you know that? You're the one who didn't clarify. No, she's not. Not that much older. 12, 13 years, I think. He's in the Alliance. Ah. He nodded, so there's the problem. Not just that. She shook her head dismissively, eyes on the bottle in her lap, fingers nailed, peeling at the label. When I went into the end school, he was one of the officers who did the initial training. I'm not even in the Alliance, but I can name 10 different regulations that broke. Yeah, maybe a few more. And I know what you're thinking. Did I make it as an N1 just because of our relationship? But no. And here she was adamant about her words, hands cutting through the air to dismiss the notion. It didn't start until after I finished, and besides, we were passed or dismissed by a council anyway. I wasn't going to say. It was stupid, she went on, and from the way she spoke, eyes far away and settled on a distant piece of floor rather than him, it was clear she was talking more for herself than for him. And it went on for far too long. There wasn't any way for it to end other than for us to get caught and ruin both our careers. So when I found out I was getting assigned to the Normandy, I called it off. For good. Shepard wasn't a by-the-book kind of soldier. She followed the rules when she could, but if pushed, make her own way, carve her own path. It was probably why and how she earned the N7 designation, and definitely the reason she was one of the few specters in the entire galaxy. Even so, Garrus hadn't expected that kind of confession from her. In most ways, he idolized her for the things she did. He wouldn't easily confess it. But he had her on a pedestal, looked at her like someone a little more like than the rest of them. So as she sat beside him and bared a small piece of herself, he saw that pedestal crumbling, breaking, falling. But it didn't ruin the image he had held of her. Rather, it brought something else to the table. She was just as fallible as the rest, and in spite of it, she still succeeded where others failed. So what made you think you should go see him again, then? That, is a good question. Where she'd been modeling in Solemn before, the smile returned to her, no doubt thanks to her inebriation. It's called You Haven't Gotten Laid in Months, and when your ex-boyfriend comes booty calling after your mug is plastered all over the news and extranet because you saved everyone's collective asses, your hand doesn't feel like enough anymore. You took a much-needed breath. Yes, that was a very long sentence.
Turian's impressive lung capacity.
That was Shepard! Humans, impressive lung capacity. If he'd been drinking, he'd have spit out whatever was in her mouth at her. Instead, he settled for a token cough. His body warmed oddly at the thought. Oh, so you know what I mean? Shepard cocked her head and continued to wear that grin. She'd chosen her words well. Garrus downed the rest of his drink for dramatic effect.
You know?
Well,
nothing.
I actually thought you and Caden had something going on. He'd seen the way Caden had looked at her, like a puppy dog almost, eager to follow her every move in order, even, no, especially, if it led him to her bed. Garrus had even seen him head up to her quarters the night before Ilios, not returning until morning. He'd only assumed what everyone else did, as well. Her face wrinkled. Almost was, but even if I was already breaking every reg in the book and stealing the Normandy, it didn't feel right to add another to the list.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah, it did. Caden. It would have certainly complicated things. Yeah. Her head hung in a heavy nod. Another sip, this time longer than all the rest. She had shut her eyes for an extended moment. It was for the best, though, especially since we're both going to be on the Normandy together indefinitely. I don't need that hanging over my head, or him thinking he's got some claim on me, some in with the boss.
I think our Miss Phryne might be jaded.
Our Miss Phryne or this Miss Phryne?
This Miss Phryne.
Yeah, this Miss Phryne's a little jaded.
Jump the fucking wall.
No! No, I won't do it!
No, Ronnie, I won't do it.
Yes. I forgot how different Turian ships are, he said with a shake of his head. There's a benefit to, blowing off steam, if you catch my drift. I do. Keeps everyone focused, and we all know it doesn't mean more than just what it was. Interest peaked. She questioned him, laughed at her tone. You're just... What the hell? Are your freezers space-going orgy? Jealous? Exaggeratedly, she tugged on the crotch of her trousers, feigning discomfort. No. Just wondering if Turians have got the number of STIs humans do. Your dick must be a cesspool of disease, Garrus. Speaking of, if my sister or her boyfriend is watching, this would be a good time to turn this off.
Nah.
Yes.
5 minutes ago would have been a good time to turn this off.
Yes. Go back in time and pretend you did not hear any of this. Exaggerate. Okay. You're the one drawing conclusions. I was joking. Do you even have a penis? This is where things are going to get even more awkward.
You know, given the graphic nature of this conversation, I feel like she would have called it a dick.
Right?
Like, I don't see this shepherd saying penis after all of this. That's just me, though.
You don't come here. We shut down machines. Break fans.
Okay.
Everyone choke and die. Then collectors make us strong.
Oh, I mean, why are you
doing this?
Obviously the collectors.
There we go.
Collectors want plague. You work for doctor. Turn on machines. Put cure in air. We kill you first.
How did you learn to speak?
Ouch.
I'm just curious.
Come on, please, thank you. I mean, you can keep reading. I'm just enacting the dick shooting plan.
While they'd been playful a moment before, Garrus gave real pause. Moment, mouth opening and closing, sputtering for response. What do you think we have? Do you think we mind meld to reproduce? Release spores? I don't know. Maybe you lay eggs. Everyone says Turians look like birds or dinosaurs, but I'm in the insect camp, and insects lay eggs. That's just cruel.
So did birds and dinosaurs, you stoop. What? Everything you just lit. Oh, God.
Yeah, but insects lay eggs and then have them fertilized on the outside of their body.
So do fish.
Yes, but birds and dinosaurs, like, have sex. I mean, I don't know about dinosaurs. We don't really know a lot about them, but definitely
tell
birds.
Me about the dinosaurs again, Lenny.
They have sex. Dinosaurs have sex.
Name of your autobiography. Dinosaurs have sex.
Name of my autobiography? Because I'm not naming it that.
Come on, it would be great. It would sum everything up.
Would it? Would it really? Besides, I'm not the one rolling around the galaxy blowing off steam with anything that moves. That's you, if you recall. With other Turians, not with... I don't have a foreign subscription like you did back on. That wasn't mine. Yeah, okay. She nodded with embellishment, the corner of her mouth working into a smile. You just read it from the articles, big guy? Joker! Oh, don't blame everything on Joker.
Just
most things. You're a strapping young Turian lad, Garrus. If you didn't jerk off at some point while you were on the Normandy, I'd be worried about you. Frankly, I don't know how we managed to get the best of Saren if you were as busy with your hand as you seem to imply, Shepard. That was it. Turn the tables. No wonder you spent so much time in your cabin. We're not talking about me. Besides, I'm a lady. Ladies don't do that.
Have a nice trip.
You just said...
talked about doing that.
That's what he just said. I have no recollection of to what you are referring. His eyes narrowed at her, and he returned the expression. It only took a moment for both to give in to the laughter that bubbled in their throats. Shepard heaved with belated breaths, tears forming at the corner of...
Belated breaths? Not bated breaths?
Belated breaths.
Okay.
Tears forming at the corner of her eyes. She wiped them away as the giggle subsided. I'm actually offended with how little they feature humans in the Fornax. A brow plate rose, a silent comment on her admission that for all her earlier teasing, Shepard was frequent reader of the galaxy's most popular publication. Need to find your niche, I guess. Besides, you do look awfully similar to the Asari. You're nothing special.
You're done!
Nothing special? The comment renewed her, and though her movements weren't as graceful, planned, or fluid as they were in battle, or for that matter, just when she wasn't drinking, Shepard managed to rise to her knees, setting the bottle aside. That was me. Garrus, you'd be taking that back if you'd been with a human. Yeah, well, he shrugged casually. I haven't. And I'll never understand the appeal of those, a hand motion to the general direction of her breasts.
But everyone likes you, sorry.
Apparently not Garrus.
Dick shooting plan.
Therefore, your children, and somehow they make more people hot? Spirits, it doesn't make any sense. And kissing. I don't know how you're all not dead. Well, we have lips, Garrus, so that definitely helps.
You know what?
Kissing. What?
At least he acknowledges he doesn't know how to kiss.
Cost-benefit analysis, she said, as though the answer was plain as day. It feels damn good, so it's worth the risk of catching something. Besides, it's not like we're kissing the people hacking and gagging. He was firm in his denial, even as he was otherwise distracted from filling his glass with lost shields. You are just bitter, she hummed. Bitter, you look like an ant, and no one's ever wanted to kiss you. I don't really describe him as looking like an ant.
Okay. Insect. She's in the insect camp.
Laughter poured out of him. Yeah, that's definitely it. You know, Garrus, and this time her voice was a bit purer, coquettish and low as she crawled over the bit of space between them. She pushed his hovering hand, the one with his glass, aside. I could give you lessons with the glass nicely. His eyes widened where he sat, locked on her with that thing in the universe to pull them away. Saren could rise from the dead, burst into the apartment with the senior Vicarian in a headlock, and Garrus wouldn't be able to look anywhere else. He stuttered, you've had too much to drink.
Does the senior Vicarian imply that he's Garrus Jr.?
Potentially.
For a friend.
Yes, I have, she agreed with a nod, but continued her movements anyway, this time a hand rising to stroke over his forearm, feeling the hard ridge of the plates beneath the cloth of his sleeve. So I've got a good excuse. Now come here.
Thank you.
Oh my god, that motion hurt my shoulder. I'm going down.
Don't make me laugh, my muscles are so tired I might drown.
Environmental systems engaged, airborne viral levels dropping, patients improving, Vorcha retreating. Well done, Shepard. Thank you.
And thank you for me as well. Those Batarians would have killed me.
Yeah.
For a second there, I thought you were going to shoot them even after they let me go.
I mean, I thought about it, but I don't think our Phryne's like that.
Our Phryne's not like that.
I made a promise to spare them if they let you go. I honor my promises.
Merciful of you. Risky. Would have killed them myself.
Okay.
Professor, how can you say that? You're a doctor.
He's a Dr. McNinja.
Lots of ways to help people. Sometimes heal patients, sometimes execute dangerous people. Either way helps. Go check on the patients. Lots of work to do. Think about what I said.
About killing people? I don't think he's going to.
Good kid. Bit naive. He'll learn. Letting him take over the clinic. Should be able to handle it now that Vorcha are gone.
Will you join me?
We've cured the plague. Are you ready to help stop the collectors?
Yes. Unexpected to be working with Cerberus. Many surprises. Just need to finish up here at the clinic. Won't take long. Meet you at your ship. Looking forward to it.
I'm gonna look around for a moment.
Plus five renegade? What did I do?
You decided to stay?
I know you. From the apartment. You found me.
Yes.
You told Mordin about me, didn't you?
Glad I could help.
That ends this.
Okay, not all humans are enemies.
Remember this the next time you're about to judge our species.
I was wrong about you, human. I was wrong about a lot of things.
The last time I saw you, you were too weak to move.
Two of Morden's assistants found me. They gave me the vaccine and brought me back here once I was stable. They were humans, but they risked their lives to find me and bring me to safety.
That's right.
You're okay.
I owe you my life, human. Thank you.
Can I tell you my name so you don't just call me human?
Nope, we are human.
Oh, no. Okay.
Human.
Now, come here. Her hand grappled with his collar. Really? You weren't suspicious about the fact that he cut down all the
all those people
and all the blue suns?
Thanks for bringing us here. You probably saved our lives.
This clinic gave me sanctuary during the plague. Saved anyone.
Perfect.
With the Vorcha gone, the blue suns should be able to regain control.
You can keep reading. I don't think any of these people.
Okay.
Blue
suns. Her hands grappled with his collar, fingers pulling at a mixture of fabric and his actual body beneath it. And when she drew herself in near to him, Garrus could not only feel the heat of her breath, but smell the alcohol on her tongue. She may have been the one doing the accosting, but all the same, he felt as though he was taking advantage, even if she clearly wasn't as far gone as he first thought. Garrus gripped her upper arm, holding her steady but not pushing her back. Their eyes met so close he nearly went dizzy from the proximity of green eyes to his blue. Stay still, she urged, talking through her wide smile. Don't be a baby. You're what, 30 years old? And you still haven't had your first kiss. 29, he corrected, even though that should have been the furthest thing from his mind. 29, then. You've traveled the galaxy, Garrus. Time to open yourself up to new opportunities. Brows furrowed, she tried again. Fuck it. She pressed her mouth into his. I said opportunities, but it only had opper. I thought that...
Oh, okay. I was just like...
Yeah, that was me.
I wasn't fully listening, but...
That was me. I...
You haven't even been drinking. You're so tired.
I'm so tired. My eyes hurt. They're so tired. Fuck it. She pressed her mouth to his. To say he felt like a floundering fish would have been putting it mildly.
Welcome to the North.
Where he was hard, she was soft. Where his plates were dry, yes, her lips were moist. Cerberus, where she was surprised and caution. Shepard's fierce determination. Branching out,
maybe? Not this so is a good place to end, because this is the end of this episode. It's just they're about to start making out, so I'd say we tease them with this kiss and then...
Alright, can I just finish this paragraph?
Yeah, sure.
And what was more, was that even though it was foreign and strangely odd, Garrus loved it. Okay.
You know the Elusive Man?
You know the Elusive Man.
You're very well informed. Solarian government well-connected espionage experts had top-level clearance once, retired now. Still, hear things. Informed of name only, no knowledge of man behind it. Anti-alien reputation listed as problematic.
Service hasn't changed.
Don't kid yourself, Professor. Humans still come first in the Elusive Man's eyes, but this mission is too big for them to handle alone.
The Collectors are abducting human colonists out on the fringes of Terminus space.
Not simple abductions. Wouldn't need me for simple.
Entire colonies disappear without a trace. No distress signals are sent out. There are no signs of any kind of attack. There's virtually no evidence that anything unusual happened at all, except that every man, woman, and child is gone.
Gas, maybe? No, spreads too slow.
Airborne virus.
You don't have to sit there and guess. We collected samples from one of the colonies. I'd like
you
to
analyze them. They sometimes just disappear in mid-conversation.
Oh, I hit the Paragon option. Changed the course of it.
There's a fully equipped lab on the combat deck, Professor Solas. If you find anything lacking, please place a requisition order.
Who's that? Pilot? No. Synthesized voice. Simulated emotional inflections. Could it be? No. Maybe. Have to ask. Is that an AI?
Yes.
The ship is equipped with an artificial intelligence.
An AI on board. Non-human crew members. Cerberus more desperate than I thought.
The Collectors have taken tens of thousands of colonists. We'll do whatever we have to do to find and stop them.
Yes, of course. Can't risk being captured like colonists. Need to identify, neutralize technology. Need samples. Which way to the lab?
Follow me, Professor.
Jacob was like, oh my god. What has happened to my life?
I thought Garrus was bad.
No.
No?
No.
That face.
No.
What?
No. So is this where we end?
I'd say this is a good place to end.
So Garrus...
Garrus has just kissed Miss Shepard.
Well, Miss Shepard has just kissed Garrus, and he loved it.
Oh, yeah. Mandibles. And you can pick this up when we go to Omega.
Omega? I thought we were on Omega.
Not Omega. Sorry, the Citadel.
There we go. Citadel.
And recruit some more people in our next episode.
Yes.
I am Wheelord.
I'm Petpluto. I really hurt from rock climbing and then falling.
This has been Mass Effect Episode 2. No, Mass Effect 2, Episode 5.
5?
5.
5.
Thanks for watching.